welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. TCU has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Here comes the pressure. At about the 47-yard line.
Wide receivers' role in a play-action pass is to get into position and hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play-action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at. But make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
He's taken down at the 40-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. That'll make it 2nd and 7. Gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Nice catch. First down. He's knocked out.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
He just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
36 second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. He scrambles. And down he goes, right around the 16-yard line. Incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Oklahoma could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Horned Frogs have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. He has some room. He gets to about the 41-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Nice run up the middle. Makes it 2nd and 6. It's 2nd down, 6 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Hey, watch the screen, watch the screen. Winning.
Tackle
tackle made
around the 43-yard line.
I think a corner loves to have a chance to come up and make a play in the run game. So often they get labeled as just great athletes, and they just want to be involved in the passing game and being able to defend the receiver. Here, you see an attitude from this corner as he comes up, reads the play, and makes the play in the backfield.
Gets to about the 44-yard line. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line. A scoring drive the last time out for this offense, and they'll huddle up for this drive.
The Horned Frogs running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground, incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. First down grab by the receiver, and he's hit immediately.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Oklahoma is up a field goal. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 17, the intended
from the 48-yard line. Second down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They'll bring him down at the 40. To the receiver, and he's got it again. He's tackled around the 24-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. A first down. Nice play to set up first and goal. And now he's got room to run. Touchdown, Sooners. What a spectacular run by the quarterback.
Such a weapon for your offense when you have a quarterback who can do things like that. The coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
The score now, 10-0. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 28. Their last drive ended in a punch, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Gets out to about the 31. From their own 31-yard line, second down. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
tailback.
And he's leveled at the 35-yard line.
So the defense does their job well on that series.
Very nicely done here by the defense. They did a good job of keeping them in check on their side of the field.
The Horned Frogs had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup.
And this one is a beauty. And he's taken down at the 38.
Oklahoma staff was talking all week long that this offense wanted to get off to a strong start, and they have.
They have. They talked about building that momentum early in the game and then trying to be able to hold on into the second half, where they've gotten off to a great start so far.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Quick throw, and they make the stop
right around the 42-yard line. And we've reached the end of one. 10-0 Sooners. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. He makes his way to about the 45. Strike, and he drops it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down around the 35-yard line. To that quickly. Brought down right around the 28-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. That's a great tackle at the 13. Second down and about 2 yards to go. Scrambling around. Room around the corner. It's away from him. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. It was an 8-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. The Horned Frogs saw one of their top players going down earlier. Looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Gets out to around the 35. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. That makes it first and 10.
And a quick throw. Tackle at the 49. It's first and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. It it out to about the 39. He's at the 30, and he is drilled at the 24-yard line.
The option's one of the more difficult plays to defend. The defense went after the quarterback, which left the running back with plenty of room.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24. Middle. They'll get him for a loss, and the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
From the 29-yard line, it's third down. He's under pressure. They'll make the sack. The pressure got to him that time.
Now, they brought the heat here, and the linebacker was able to spring free for a big play.
The kick is up, it's got the distance, and he nails the long field goal. TCU is ready to kick it away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Sooners are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Nice pass there, and the quarterback was under a lot of pressure from the defense.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
He's taken down to 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. Got a man, watch out here. And down he goes, at about the 41. Steps out of bounds at the 46-yard line. That's a deep one.
That makes it 4 inches.
Blue 20.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. TCU's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does. And now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion of the game a little bit, and they're going to have to do it with somebody else, I think.
This is really where a coaching staff gets challenged, because for 5 or 6 days you prep and you look at a lot of film and you kind of come into a game by the time Saturday rolls around and you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense. And then you go out there and it's not working. You have to show an ability as a coaching staff to go back and look at that drawing board and eliminate some things and maybe add some things and be able to try to make the adjustments you need to give your team a chance to win in the second half.
And they get nice yardage on that run. TCU's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From their own 48-yard line, it's first down. Slings it. And he hauls it in. And they push him out at the 26. He goes out of bounds at the 18-yard line.
That's a deal. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. He's on the run. He's taken off. Decides to slide. Just throws this one away. We've played a half of football here. Oklahoma's lead is 2 touchdowns.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. You can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 26. He scrambles. And he tackles him hard at the 35.
That's good for gaining 9 yards. Third down.
Looking for the corner. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line. First down. Gets out to around the 45.
Gain of 12 yards. First down.
That's three. Pass. My 40. 10. 28.
Breaks it up the middle for a nice run. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. The ball is loose, and they fall on the loose ball. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. The Horned Frogs running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up and trying to get back in the ballgame. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. And he's tackled around the 26-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Fires it out. He's tackled at the 17-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Third trip now into the red zone. They'll bring him down at the 20. That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3. This is the 11th play of this drive. Gets out to around the 12. From the 12-yard line, first down. Tackled for a loss.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
This is the 13th play of this drive. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. They go with a run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. From the 19-yard line, it's third down. The Horned Frogs quarterback down there on the sideline, and Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain right now. They need him back. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. Like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They're ready to begin another drive. Oklahoma is up a score. Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop at the 33. Gets to around the 42. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Middle, got his back, and he's taken down around the 47-yard line.
Now, I think he's got a good rhythm going right now with his wide receivers. He hit him for a nice game.
Brought down around the 44-yard line. To about the 34-yard line. That's three down and one to go. Oklahoma's lead is a touchdown. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Oklahoma up 7 points. Makes the first down catch. Tackle at about the 25-yard line. Now he's flushed and they got it.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 30-yard line. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down at the 18. They come out in an empty backfield.
Easy, easy.
Throws. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
It was a textbook post route, and the pass was right on target. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review, they decided that the call on the field will stand. And he adds the extra point. A nice 10-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 22. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession. Looks for his tight end over the middle. He's out to the 30. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line. It's first down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. He's at midfield, and he's finally shoved out at the 43.
It's gonna be a long day.
Looking for his man, incomplete.
The receiver couldn't catch up to that ball.
No, he couldn't, and I'll tell you what, the quarterback was conscious of the blitz that time by the defense. That may have been the reason that he overthrew the football.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's gobbled up in the backfield. And they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
Third down now. They need to get it down to the 33. Up the middle. Gets to about the 44-yard line. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Going long.
Well, if there's one thing I learned in this game, it's to never count a team out. There's still enough time on this clock for these guys to come back and win this game.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a 1st and 10. Gets it out to him again, and down he goes, around the 6-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Touchdown, Horned Frogs.
You know, they're going to have a big decision when they line up for the kickoff. Onside or kick it away and try to get a quick 3 and out.
And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense can continue the flow that we've seen from the previous 3 series.
A score here might effectively end this one. Run, and he's brought down. TCU's going to use their 1st time out of the half here. So it's 2nd down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the 1st. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Over the middle to his tailback. Tackle made around the 34-yard line. He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Out to his receiver, and he's tackled at the 42.
That was actually pretty good defense, but a great pass and a great catch were enough to overcome it.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. From the 42-yard line, 2nd down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Two.
gets to about the 27-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. TCU staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.